A quick disclaimer, I am being paid to make this video by the European Union and NS Kojari as part of a series meant to share several wonderful geologic features within the nation of Slovakia. What you are looking at is a specimen of Slovakian opal which contains multiple shades of brown. This is no ordinary common opal, as its name of wood opal hints at its true origin. In other words, this is a piece of wood that was buried more than 10 million years ago and over a significant period of time was replaced with opal. As approximately 14 million years ago, a powerful volcanic eruption occurred from the Poľana volcano. This sent pyroclastic flows in all directions around the mountain, which moved at speeds exceeding 150 kilometers per hour. Along the way, they flattened dozens of square kilometers of thick forest, causing trees to burn and fall, which were then subsequently buried by a layer of thick ash. The aforementioned eruption sequence occurred during the opening stages of Poľana's caldera-forming eruption, which caused this once glacier-topped 3,500-meter-high stratovolcano to collapse to a height of only 1,500 meters. Today, you can see the remnants of the 6-kilometer-wide caldera which is breached to the west alongside the 190-square-kilometer outline this volcano once held. And once Poľana eventually became extinct, it would only be 500,000 years before a separate group of 5 stratovolcanoes near the border of Ukraine would erupt, forming what are known as the Vihorlat Hills. As, while Poľana erupted between 15 and 13 million years ago, the 5 volcanoes in the Vihorlat Hills erupted between 12.5 and 9.5 million years ago. This is the story of these two volcanic complexes, which erupted at approximately the same time as several other stratovolcanoes and cinder cones during a time period when Slovakia was far more geologically active than it is today. Approximately 15 million years ago, a vast inland sea known as the Pannonian Sea existed, which was approximately half the size of the modern Black Sea and covered swaths of Austria, Slovakia, Hungary, Slovenia, Croatia, Serbia, Romania, Bosnia and Herzegovina, and Ukraine. For a time while this sea existed, the same mantle source fed what would become two separate volcanoes 50 kilometers apart, likely being connected by a magma reservoir in the lowermost crust. The southwestern volcano would eventually become the Skocnica supervolcano, while the northeastern volcano would become Poľana. While Skocnica was beginning to climb above the seafloor, Poľana was also erupting, but did not produce any submarine eruptions as it started 50 meters above the level of the adjacent sea and 25 kilometers inland from its edge. This volcano produced numerous moderately sized volcanic eruptions over hundreds of thousands of years, depositing interwoven layers of ash alongside thick layers of blocky andesite lava. These andesite lava lobes were up to 50 meters thick, and over some eruptions that lasted more than a year, traveled up to 11 kilometers distant. By 14 million years ago, this great-topped stratovolcano had grown to 3,500 meters, or 11,483 feet above sea level. Before the Skocnica supervolcano produced its cataclysmic eruption, Poľana produced an ultra-Plinian eruption that devastated the landscape in a 25-kilometer radius, causing this volcano to collapse into a caldera. Within the final 1 million years of its lifespan, a few smaller eruptions produced andesite, dacite, and rhyolite lava domes within its caldera. Beginning 12.5 million years ago and 200 kilometers to the east, a new set of volcanoes began to grow. Unlike Poľana, these volcanoes all initially erupted through the shallow seafloor along an ancient beach, creating large deposits of solidified volcanic ash known as tuff. These layers of tuff reached up to 50 meters thick, forming the initial shallow platform which the volcanoes would later grow from. Fast forward 200,000 years and 5 great-top stratovolcanoes each measuring 10 to 15 kilometers wide had been constructed, largely from a combination of strombolian and less common volcanian eruptions. If you were to walk around any of these volcanic remnants in the Vihorlat Hills today, you would find numerous pillars and boulders of layered, gray and acidic lava flows. While most of these horizontal fractures formed long after the lava cooled, they can help show us which direction the lava was flowing, which, as an example, moved from left to right in this image. The edges of these lava flows contain piles of andesitic rubble, as the advancing lava flows had sides exceeding 45 degrees slopes. While the Vihorlat volcano would go on to become the tallest volcanic cone of the group, reaching 2,500 meters in height, it and the 3 closest volcanic cones produced fairly low gas content in their eruptions. The 5th volcano, which primarily exists in Ukraine, was different, producing far more powerful explosive eruptions. This volcano, referred to as Vihorlat Poprishny, would eventually climb to a height of 2,000 meters, being covered by numerous domes of both dacite and rhyolite lava. Around 10 million years ago, this volcano ceased erupting, but not before it partially collapsed into a 3.5-kilometer-wide caldera. Today, all of these aforementioned volcanoes are extinct and will never erupt again, but provide for some beautiful scenery and interesting rock formations.